So we are going to see some numericals that are in your textbook and that are not solved. So these numericals are also important. So instead of starting new chapter, I thought that we'll discuss these numericals and move further. So these are the numericals to find efficiency. So we know the formula we have learnt in last lecture, that efficiency is equal to output divided by output plus losses. So losses are of iron loss and copper loss. So copper loss varies and iron loss is constant. So how does this copper loss varies? Now if they have asked us to find the copper loss for the half load, that means as per the load changes, our copper loss also changes. So the formula is full load copper loss multiply by how much percentage we have to change that square, right? So we will see in the numericals. Yesterday we have seen this. So to find efficiency, we first have to know the output, right? So this output is full load output. First we have to find the full load output. So we will see here. A 100 kVA transformer has a full load copper loss of 3 kW and full load iron loss of 2 kW. Find the efficiency of transformer under following conditions. Now they have given here the first condition. We will see the first condition. So the first condition says full load at unity power factor. So we have to calculate efficiency at full load unity power factor. So our losses, they have given us losses, that is copper loss and iron loss. These losses they have given at full load copper loss, right? So here full load copper loss and full load iron loss. So there is no need to calculate copper loss. They have given in full load copper loss. So first step is what? We know the formula of efficiency. We have to find the output. We know the losses now. Now we have to find the output. So what is the formula of output? So here output, that is full load output. So formula is KVA into power factor. Right, so they have given here 100 kVA. Power factor is unity power factor. So unity power factor means 1. Okay, unity power factor means 1. So here we will substitute the values, that is full load output equal to KVA, that is 100, into power factor that they have given as unity, that is 1. So here our answer is 100 kW. So full load output, our output is 100 kW. Now we have to calculate the efficiency at full load. According to their first condition, full load unity power factor, find the efficiency. So we know the formula. Efficiency is equal to output divided by output plus losses. So here output is 100 kW. All the units are in kW. Just remember, we have to concentrate on kW units. So all the units must be in same. All units must be same. Now this our output is in kW. Losses they have given in kW, right? Iron loss and copper loss they have given in kW. So we can substitute here. So 100, that is output divided by output plus losses. So what are the losses? That is iron loss and copper loss. So iron loss they have given as 2 kW and copper loss is 3. So here 100 divided by, this will be 5, and 100 plus 5, that is 105. So after solving this, we get, and main thing, don't forget to multiply it by 100. So percentage efficiency is equal to, after solving this, we get answer as 95.24%. So this is the efficiency at full load unity power factor. So first thing what you have to understand, first you have to calculate the output. So we have asked us to find the efficiency. So we know the formula. From formula itself, we need to calculate output. So what is the formula of output? KVA ratings into power factor. So KVA, they have already given 100 KVA, and power factor for first condition, they have asked us to find for unity power factor. That means one power factor. So full load output is equal to, we substituted in the values 100 KVA, that is 100 into 1, that is 100. Now we know the copper loss and iron loss. They have mentioned that it is full load copper loss and full load iron loss. So we substituted the values here in losses. We added the losses, iron loss and copper loss, and we got the answer, that is efficiency, full load efficiency at unity power factor, that is 95.24. Now second condition. Now what is the second condition? Half load, 0.5 power factor. Now what they have said, in first case what we calculated, full load power factor, full load efficiency at unity power factor. Full load means what, we are giving 100% the load, the capacity, maximum capacity, we are giving the full load. Now half load, half load means half of the maximum, that means it is 50% of load at 0.5 power factor. So this is full load and this is half load. We have to calculate efficiency at half load at 0.5 power factor. Now what is the main thing? What is the first thing? We have to calculate the output, and second thing, losses. Now here we have asked to find efficiency at 50% and losses are given at full load, right? That is 100%. They have given the losses at full load, that is 100%. Now what we have to do? We have to convert these losses or calculate these losses in 50%. We know iron loss is constant, so there is no need to change this 2 kW. Iron loss is constant, so we have to just change this copper loss. Why? Because it varies with load. Now here our load is half, we have half the load, right? Now we will first calculate the output and then we'll go to this loss, that is copper loss. Now how to calculate the output? So here first we have to calculate output for full load. We cannot take this output. Why? Because power factor is different. Here power factor is different. So considering this power factor, we have to calculate output here. So full load output is equal to KVA into power factor. So what is our KVA? 100. They have given us 100. And what is power factor? They have asked us to find out this power factor, that is 0.5. So after calculating this, our answer is 50 kW, right? So what we have did here, considering this power factor 0.5, first we have to calculate full load output. So our output at full load is 50 kW. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate output because we have to calculate efficiency at 50%, right? So this efficiency we have to calculate 50%. So our output must be at also 50%. So this is our full load output. Now we have to calculate half load. That means for 100% or full load output, our at full load output is 50 kW. And now at 50% load, how much will be our output? So after solving this, that is 100x equal to 50 into 50. So 100x equal to 25,000. So for calculating the x, 25,000 divided by 100, that is x equal to 25. So our output at 50% load, that is half load, is 25. So in formula we are going to substitute this value, that is 25%, right? So what I did here, first I calculated full load output and then we have asked us to find efficiency at half load. So we must know the output at half load. So what I did, for full load, that is 100%, 50 kW is the output. Then what will be the output for 50%? Right, so I cross multiplied it. 100x is equal to 50 into 50. 100x is equal to 25,000. And after solving this for x, we get the answer x is equal to 25. There is again one method that I have told you in last lecture also. So what you can do, here only you can calculate the half load, right? So what does it mean by 50%? That is 50 divided by 100, right? So this will be 1 by 2. So this is in fraction, right? This is in fraction. So in this full load output only you can calculate directly the half load output. So how you have to just calculate? That is KVA into power factor into the value in fraction, that is half. So we will solve in this way also. KVA is 100, power factor is 0.5 into 1 by 2. So this will be 50, and 50 multiplied by 0.5, it is 25. So you can calculate half load output by this also or by this method also. So whatever you feel is, you can go for it. First you have to calculate full load output, and after calculating this full load output, they have asked us to find at 50%, right? So we will just cross multiply it. If they might have asked us for 25%, so 100% for full load it is 50%, and for 25 how much? So we can calculate this way also. If they ask you to calculate for 25%, you can do it this way. So our output, we got the output. So output at 50% is 25. Now, formula of efficiency is equal to output divided by output plus losses. So losses, iron loss and copper loss. But our copper loss varies as the load changes. So our load here has changed, that we have told to find at half load. So to find copper loss, to find the copper loss formula, as I told you, full load copper loss. So there we know full load copper loss, that is 3 kW. So here we can write 3 kW, and at how much percent we have to calculate at half load, that means 1/2, and square of it, we have to do square of it. So after solving it, so it is 3/4. So 3/4 means what? Our copper loss is 0.75, right? So we got our copper loss at half load. Now we can calculate the efficiency, because we have all the terms. So here efficiency is equal to output divided by output plus iron loss plus copper loss. Now what is the output? 25 divided by 25 plus what is iron loss? It is constant, so it is 2 kW plus what is our copper loss we have calculated here, that is 0.75, right? So adding this, it will be 25 divided by 27.75, and after solving this we will get the efficiency as 90%. So this is our efficiency at half load, and this is for the full load. That is, they have given us two conditions, full load and half load. I hope you have understood this example. So just remember, first you have to calculate the output and then go to the losses. Output, full load output, they have given the full load losses, copper loss and iron loss. First calculate the full load output, and then if they have asked us to find at 25%, then just by cross multiplying it, you can get it. So this is the example number 12. Now we will go to the star delta example. So yesterday we have seen the problem, one problem on the star delta. First we will draw the diagram, right? So three phase delta connected 200 kVA load, that is delta connected, the connection of our load is delta, right? We will draw here delta connected, this is our load. It is to be supplied by 6600 by 500 volts star star connected transformer. So transformer is star star connected, that means the primary side and secondary side, right? So this is star connected, so this is our primary, secondary, and this is our load, right? So for your understanding, you just draw this diagram first and then draw the main diagram like this. So from the question, they have given the three-phase delta connected 200 kVA load. That means our load is delta connected. So we have written here load delta connected is to be supplied by 6600 by 500 volts star-star connected transformer. That means star-star, it is primary, and secondary side, it is star-star connected. So, what we have asked, find the voltage and current on both sides. So, first we will draw the diagram. So, this is our primary side that is connected in star. So, we will draw the diagram. So, there is no need to show the neutral. So, this is our primary, right? And secondary is connected at, this is also connected as star. Okay, this is connected as star. And our load is connected as delta. Now, our load that is connected as delta. So this is our diagram. Okay, so this is primary, secondary, and this is load. So load is connected to secondary, right? So primary, secondary, and this is our load. Now 200 kVA load, that means they have given the load here, 200 kVA load supplied by 6600 volts. That means they have given the primary side voltage and secondary side voltage, right? They have given this. Now what we have asked, to find the voltage and current on both the sides. Now from this diagram we are able to see, this is the primary, secondary. We know the primary line voltage, we know the primary secondary line voltage. From this only we got to know primary line voltage, that is 6600 volts, and secondary line voltage, that is 500 volts. Right. Now, here from this, what we can do, they have given us 200 kVA. We have the formula, our load is connected in delta. So, our formula for power is equal to root 3 V into I, right? V into I. So, this load is connected to secondary. So, V is this, and current, that is line current, we have to calculate from this, right? We will know the line current, and power we know here, that is 200 kVA. They have given already. So we know the formula of power is equal to root 3 V into I. Our load is connected in delta. So our formula is P is equal to root 3 V into I. We know the P value, that is 200. We know the V value, that is 500. So we can calculate this current. This current is nothing but secondary line current, right? We will calculate the secondary line current. So P is equal to 200 is equal to root 3 into 500 into I. So we have to solve for I. 200 divided by root 3 into 500. So after calculating this, our answer is, before that, we have to see all the values are in same units or not. Now here our 2000, it is in kVA, and this is volts, that is in volts. So this kilo has to be converted. So 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by root 3 into 500. Why 10 raised to 3? Because it is kilo. So we have to convert kilovolts into volt, right? So kilo stands for 10 raised to 3. So we have just substituted here this value, and after solving this, the answer is 231 amperes. So our current is 231 amperes, right? So now what we calculated, this is our secondary line current. This is secondary line current. Now we know the both voltages, that is primary line voltage, secondary line voltage. Now we know secondary line voltage. Now we have to calculate the primary line voltage. So we have the formula, that is transformation ratio, V2 divided by V1 is equal to I1 divided by I2. So this is connected in star, right? So this is star connected. So in star connected, current is same. Phase current and line current is same. The values of phase and line are same. So what we'll do here, we'll substitute the values. So here 6600 divided by 500 equal to I1 we have to find, and I2 we have calculated, that is 231 ampere. Right. Now 6600 divided by 500 into 231, that is equal to primary current. Right. So after solving this, we get answer as 17.5 ampere. So this is our primary current. We have calculated secondary current, and from this diagram we know primary and secondary voltages. So this is about the numericals. So numericals are very important. You can score out of marks in numericals. So please prefer numericals over theory, so that you will score more in your boards. So to do the examples, you just have to remember that in phase, that in delta or star. So in delta, the voltage values, that is line and phase, are same, right? And in star connection, line values, that is current and phase, line and phase, they are same, right? In current, in star, current values are same, and in delta, voltage values are same. Just you have to remember that. And if you have any doubts, you can ask.